So my name is Robert Fellows. I'm a clinical psychology doctoral student, and we are in the Memory and Aging Lab at Washington State University. We have a lot of different aims in our lab here, but one of the overarching aims is to kind of look at how older adults' cognitive abilities, so like learning, memory, concentration, impacts their ability to carry out everyday tasks. And what we're trying to do is identify how those two things are connected so that we can develop strategies to help people with cognitive difficulties better and more effectively interact with their environment. So I'm originally from Connecticut. In elementary school and middle school and high school, I always kind of struggled with math. It had always been pretty difficult for me because what we were being taught seemed so kind of abstract at the time. You know, when you're teaching someone how to do algebra, you know, the question that you always get is, well, how does this apply to my life? And that's kind of how I felt. So it was challenging for me to make the connection with how it would be applied. But once I kind of learned how some of these problems were applied to the everyday world, that's kind of how I started to understand it better and kind of started to learn it a little differently, I guess, than we were taught in school. We often see people coming in to our lab to participate in our studies that are starting to experience some cognitive difficulties. And often at this early stage, they're aware of it, and it can be very distressing. It can be very distressing for them and their families that they're starting to lose this part of them. And when we see that on kind of this regular basis, that, you know, alone is a really strong motivator to kind of keep things moving and moving in a direction that's going to directly help, you know, people that are having these types of difficulties. In our lab, we are really kind of geared towards developing interventions and kind of assisting older adults with some of the cognitive and functional difficulties that they may be having. Part of that is developing technologies to kind of help with day-to-day memory tasks and remembering to do things like remembering to take medications and remembering to turn off the stove and developing technologies to identify patterns of behavior in a way that will be helpful for older adults. One of the great things about working in a lab like this is that we have the opportunity for a lot of collaboration. And one of the great things about it is that when you're collaborating in this type of environment, you are contributing to something that's greater than yourself, and that's really an extraordinary opportunity. Our aging population is exploding, and because we know that aging processes are often related to disability, cognitive difficulties, and I think one of the things that drives science the most and research the most is curiosity. And if you have curiosity, you can use that in any field of research, in any field of science. So find something that motivates you, that you're really interested in and curious about, and find yourself asking a lot of questions about, like, you know, why are people the way they are? Why do people develop dementia? And if you find yourself asking all these questions, maybe that's the field that you're going to be great for, because it's that curiosity that really drives us.